Today's video, we're going to talk about how you guys can actually feed deer. It's a huge topic, and I think it's something that, you know, we can provide, you know, especially on private property when we have a lot of land, a lot of hunters, you know, they're buying private land and they want to be able to increase the health of that herd. It is possible, and we're going to run over some ways on actually how to feed deer the proper way through habitat and supplementation, you know, such as food plots. So when you're feeding the deer, you have to consider deer eat 4, 6, 7, 8 pounds of food per day, depending how old that deer is. Fawns, obviously yearlings, are going to eat a little bit less food. And then as deer get older, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 years old, they require more food, you know, tonnage per day. And you have to actually realize that if you're on small properties, you have big wooded areas, you know, a lot of times food is limited in those areas. And you may see deer that are, you know, pretty skinny. You know, if their ribs are showing, that means they lack food, they're lacking nutrients in their diet, and they may not have 4 to 6, 7, 8 pounds of food, you know, available to them to consume. So that's where supplementation comes in and some habitat work. Each property is going to be different. What you have on your property may be different 15 minutes down the road. You could have two completely situations where, you know, you're on a 100-acre piece. You know, depending on what's around that 100 acres, all your deer may be healthy. You know, no rib showing, you may be good to go. Drive 15 minutes down the road could be completely different. Habitat, deer, you know, they look skinny, look sick, and all that stuff. So we're going to go over some habitat situations and some food plot situations on how to feed that deer throughout the entire year, 365 days a year, and you can actually benefit that deer. So number one is habitat. Like I mentioned, 4 to 6 pounds, depending, you know, what you read, you know, what article, what research, where the research comes from, it's somewhere in the range of 4 to 6 pounds, 4 to 8 pounds, depending, you know, how old that deer actually is. And habitat, you know, you guys have to realize, you know, before we started planting food plots, what did the deer do, right? Food plots are not designed to supplement, to feed that deer, you know, throughout the entire year, because most times we're not able to plant enough to be able to feed that deer. And besides that, deer need diversity. They need, you know, multiple different food sources, such as, you know, woody browse, bushes, briars, you know, honeysuckle. You know, there's all kinds of different varieties of plants that deer eat. They actually consume over 700 different species of browse. And I don't know all 700 of them, but that's what they consume. There's 700 different species of food that deer consume on a daily basis, depending on what time of year it is. What's palatable today may not be palatable tomorrow. They may consume, you know, some honeysuckle or something in the winter, you know, a bunch of woody browse and briars and shrubs and things like that. And you go into the spring, you got spring green up, they're eating, you know, poison ivy and goldenrod and, you know, ragweed, all kinds of different things that they consume. So the way that, you know, you feed deer is through habitat work. Before we were around, you know, food plots were around, this is what, you know, still deer consume on a daily basis is what's provided in nature through the habitat, through hardwood regeneration, you know, and prescribed fires and burns and, you know, different types of timber stand improvement, edge feathering to create extra browse. And it's the work that we do on our properties that feed the deer. It's the woody browse, the shrubs, the briars, you know, American beautyberry. There's all kinds of different, you know, species that the deer consume through the habitat that we improve on. You know, you can't supply enough corn, enough acorns, enough, you know, stuff that you dump on the ground. This stuff does not feed the deer. It has very little benefit to them. How nature, you know, and wildlife work is the deer get the nutrition through the soil and through what nature provides through forbs and grasses and, you know, everything. These plants that are there are absorbing those nutrients out of the ground, the mineral content and the micronutrients and all that go into that plant, and then the deer consume it, and that's how they get nutrition. That's how they get, you know, bigger antlers and gain body weight. If the food is not available, then the deer has no chance of, you know, increasing the body weight. A lot of times in a lot of areas, you see deer on the decline because they don't have enough food. You have closed canopy forests and all that. So don't buy into the gimmicks that you see online where they're dumping some kind of mineral on the ground, some kind of block. That stuff may be a good attractant, but it's not growing deer. It's not feeding them in a way that's meant for a wild, free-ranging deer to be fed. Okay, just don't buy into that gimmicks. You know, if you do it, they may be good attractants, and you may get some trail camera pictures, but just realize that that deer is not gaining body weight from that a lot. It may have some very minimal benefit to it, but keep following along, and we'll show you how to feed them long-term and actually gain weight. So now you have an idea of habitat and what's available and what they feed on 365 days a year, and that's how a deer gain body weight, but it has to be there, right? On areas that are closed canopy, you know, you have very little food for the deer to consume. You know, they may have a lot of grasses and, you know, goldenrod and ragweed during the spring and summer, you know, bushes and briars and things to consume, but then when you lead into the fall, you're lacking green, right? So that's when the deer transition to woody browse. And it's funny because I go to a lot of trade shows and I say, you know, we tell them, hey, deer consume woody browse, natural browse. They're like, what are you talking about? What's natural browse? It's like, come on, you know, that's a basic of being an outdoorsman and being a hunter is realizing what deer consume. People get, you know, brainwashed because of commercials and TV shows where you see hunters and stuff, you know, dumping a certain type of thing on the ground, and that's what they think these deer live on, and it's not. You know, before all this stuff was around, think of all the monster bucks and deer that were shot before we were around. You know, it's because of the habitat and, you know, good, you know, habitat that deer can feed on, you know, plenty of food around and woody browse and shrubs and all these different types of things. Keep that in mind. Number two is food plots. There's a correct way and a wrong way with food plots. Now, I say this all the time, if you just have a very small property and or very small food plot and you're trying to feed a deer with a quarter acre, forget about it. It's not going to work. You're not going to see much benefit from it. Is it going to hurt? No. Is it going to increase body weight on all the deer in your area? Probably not. The true way to supplement them, because food plots are supplemental, the true way to feed them year-round with a food plot, okay, if you have enough acreage, right, is to plant whatever you're going to plant in the summer, spring and summer, if need be, if needed, if you have large enough areas to feed them, if they need extra food in that area, each property is going to be different, like I mentioned. But to plant your spring and summer food to feed them, it could be beans, peas, it could be, you know, just planting buckwheat to improve the soil. It could be clover, you know, annual clovers. It could be anything that, you know, high in protein and improving that soil on a manicured, you know, crop, manicured soils where your lime and fertilized and micronutrient to provide that extra nutrients to give to the deer if needed. You know, some areas have enough food, some areas don't. Look at your deer herd. If their ribs are showing, they don't have enough food, okay? Leading into the fall and winter months, you guys, to feed the deer, you need to be planting winter wheat or winter rye. I prefer winter wheat over that. You can actually add some clovers in there, but the winter wheat provides food all through the fall months into the winter months. You get warm days in this wintertime, that stuff perks right up, and the deer will hammer it. What's beneficial about this is leading into the winter months, it's going to go dormant a little bit, but spring green up, I've seen it anywhere, depending on what state you're in, to where, you know, the winter wheat, the deer will hammer it 4 to 6 weeks prior to spring green up, which means you have all that tonnage, all that food available to the wildlife way before spring green up. So you're providing an additional 4 to 6 weeks of food before spring green up in a manicured crop that's physically planted by us in fertilized soil, lime soil, to where those plants can uptake all those nutrients, and you're providing that to the deer. That's feeding the deer an additional 4 to 6 weeks before spring green up. Now, when you plant winter wheat, what happens is in spring green up, all of a sudden it's like magic. You know, the deer, all of a sudden they stop hitting the winter wheat. And the reason being is a lot of times that winter wheat is growing very rapidly and all of a sudden it gets tall and it gets stemmy and woody and it's not attractive to deer anymore. The second thing is you have spring green up. So you have all the foliage in the woods greening up and it's palatable and tender. You get fresh tips on them. The deer focus on that and they consume that. That's what happens, you know, with that process. But to feed that deer an additional 4 to 6 weeks of tonnage of food per acre is very beneficial, and that's how you supplement their diet through habitat, what's there all the time, natural browse, and then supplement them with food plot as I just described. Number three, corn. I do not recommend corn. There's been many studies and research, you know, feeding deer corn. Me personally, I do not think deer are meant to eat corn at all. People use it. I've used it in the past, and I'm not saying I'll ever not use it again. I probably will someday. But when you introduce corn into a deer's diet right off the bat, it's not a good idea. You can actually kill the deer and do more harm than good. And number four, do we help? Do we need to help a deer? Now, I say this all the time. Deer know how to survive. They know what to do. They know how to live. You know, they, when it gets cold, they stop moving as much. They conserve energy, conserve calories. You know, they know how to get warm, sunny side of the fields. They know how to live. They know how to survive, and they know what to do. Can we help them? Yes, we can, as I just described, through habitat work and actually feeding them the proper way through supplemental, you know, food plot program. Food plots are supplemental. Always remember that. They live on natural browse, 4, 6, 7, 8 pounds of it per day, and we can make an impact on the herd, you know, through habitat work, excuse me. And you will see that difference if you follow these steps. You'll see the ribs start to go away. In areas that have plenty of food and you're trying to feed them, you know, you may not see as good or as much benefits. But in areas that 100% the deer ribs are showing, it lacks food, closed canopy forest, when you start doing these practices, you will see those ribs go away and you'll see maximum benefits from it. That's how you feed deer. Any questions, post them down below. Give the video a thumbs up. Subscribe if you guys are new. I'll see you on the next video. Thanks for watching this video, guys. If you want more information on food plots, soil samples, and habitat management, click this video right here on the screen. Thanks for watching. Subscribe if you guys are new.